Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll discuss the importance of data quality in Splunk, as well as some common data quality issues that may arise when ingesting data and how to tackle them.
Data quality can be measured by multiple factors. Is our data accurate, complete, reliable, and consistent? Whether we are searching for security compliance reports, sales analytics, or just failed logins, we want to know we can trust the data. Looking at the journey our data takes through Splunk, when working on resolving a data quality issue, we will be focusing on the indexer or heavy forwarder level. The parsing phase is when event processing occurs. Splunk will examine, analyze, and transform the data. The parsing phase is comprised of many subphases, such as character set encoding, breaking the stream of data into individual lines, identifying parsing and setting timestamps for events, merging multiple lines into a single event, event-by-event modifications, and much more. Commonly, in data quality issues, it's due to a lack of customization for line breaking, line merging, and timestamp extractions. Splunk can ingest almost any type of data, and thus there are default configurations for these subphases. However, in some situations, we will want to tell Splunk how we need our data parsed. Let's focus on line breaking issues first. A common symptom of a line breaking issue is when we have fewer events ingested into our index as expected. This would typically be caused by multiple events getting grouped together into one larger event. The root of the problem is an incorrect setting value for the line breaker or truncate attributes in props.conf. To diagnose a line breaking issue, we can begin by reviewing the Monitoring Console data quality dashboard. Where we should see an issue present in the line break issues column.
If we click on the source, we will see additional panels populate with the event line count, event size, and event time disparity. We can see from the event count column, there is only one event from the entire source, and it contains 133 lines. Investigating further, if we click on the issue count within the line break issues column, we will be taken to search results containing the error message.
We will also see the truncating line because of 10,000 bytes has been exceeded error message in the Splunk Web Data Input workflow when configuring the input, or in the splunkd.log file. The next step we should take is to search for the events that we believe may have an issue. Looking at our results, we can see there are many events getting grouped together, as we noted back in the data quality dashboard. Ideally, each line should be an individual event. Clicking on the source type from the field sidebar, we can confirm the current assigned source type. This was likely mistakenly assigned during the data input phase. To rectify the issue, we will delete the old test input and try again. From the Add Data menu, we select Monitor. Then, Files and Directories, and navigate through to choose the same source file of the data we want to ingest. Clicking Next, the following step is Data Preview, which allows us to see exactly how our events will be ingested. Ideally, we would resolve any data quality issues here before the data is ingested. We can see that if Splunk doesn't recognize the data as a pre-trained source type, it applies default configurations. In this case, the previous input configuration was human error, and the default configurations do successfully parse the data. We will click Save As and name the source type new_sysmon. Optionally, add a description, choose the location in the source type selection menu to save it under, and lastly, select the app context. Continuing on to the input settings, making any necessary adjustments, and reviewing the input before clicking Submit. We can now search for the newly ingested events and compare our results to before, properly parsed and exactly as they were displayed in the Data Preview menu. Next up, let's tackle event breaking issues, which are often referred to as aggregation issues, a key processor during the parsing phase. Event breaking issues typically pertain to the attributes break only before date and max events, and any props.conf configuration file setting with the keyword of break. Event breaking issues present in many different ways. You can either have multiple events being grouped together, as well as single line events that should have been merged. We will typically see one of the following errors in the Splunk data input workflow, or in the Splunk d.log file if the data's already been ingested. Similar to line breaking, aggregation issues would also be present in the data quality dashboard in Monitoring Console. It could be possible that the events are properly recognized, but are simply too large for the limits in place. However, it is much more likely that the events are not properly recognized, and thus, Splunk is not breaking events properly. In this next example, our events aren't too long, rather we need to reevaluate our breaking strategy. The default strategy breaks before the date, so if Splunk does not extract a timestamp, it does not break the event. Looking at the event, we'll expand the Event Break menu and click Regex to specify a regular expression to aid in breaking the event. Now that the events are parsed correctly, we need to investigate one last data quality issue, the timestamp extraction. Timestamp issues pertain to the date time config, time prefix, time format, max timestamp lookahead, and TZ attributes in the props.conf configuration file.
Timestamp parsing issues appear in the data quality dashboard just like the others. We would see an alert in the aggregation or timestamp columns, depending on if it's a combined issue.
We would also see some of the following errors in the Splunk data input workflow, or in the Splunk d.log file if it's already been ingested. Another key indication is if the underscore time value assigned by Splunk does not match what's in the raw data. Diving back into our previous example, our next step is fine-tuning the timestamp extraction. Expanding our event, we can see the timestamp is present in the very center, in the format of year, month, day. Let's begin with specifying the timestamp format by entering percentage capital Y for year, hyphen percentage lowercase m for month, hyphen percentage lowercase d for day. The next attribute we will update is the timestamp prefix. Action date within triangular brackets comes immediately before the timestamp in the event, so that is the value we will use. We can see our events now have an assigned timestamp, and are parsed correctly. Let's save the new source type and continue on to the next step in the data input workflow, knowing our data will be ingested correctly.
Thanks for joining us to learn how to resolve a few common data quality issues in Splunk. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.